This is Ida, rather squashed after 47 million years underground, but an extraordinary specimen, so beautifully preserved. Often fossil hunters only find scraps of bone and a few teeth, but this specimen is almost complete, and not only can you see the bones, you can even see the outline that shows where the fur on the creature once was. Extraordinary detail. They even used X-ray to examine the contents of the stomach, and they could see that she'd eaten at her last meal some fruit and leaves. And one very interesting discovery was here on the wrist, which is clearly broken. Now, she was a grasping animal. She grasped onto branches with her hands and swung from tree to tree. And perhaps the broken wrist was the reason why she didn't survive and fell into this lake and ended up as a fossil that we can study now. The scientists who've been looking at the fossil say there's a mix of characteristics. She looks a little bit like a lemur, but they say she also has more advanced characteristics that you might see in humans today. So is she our direct ancestor? Well, that's something that's going to be debated for some time. The team say she's not perhaps our great-great-great-grandmother, perhaps more of a great-great-great-aunt. Is she a missing link or not? Well, some say she is, others say that's just a cliche that is barely means anything at all. But one thing certain, scientists around the world are going to be very keen to have a look at this wonderful specimen. The scientists themselves want to study it in a lot more detail. Something no one can deny, as it simply is a wonderful specimen.
Her 47 million year old remains can be brought to life in a 21st century virtual world. Laser scanners combined with the computerized tomography produce a digital code of her body, which once processed creates an accurate 3D model. We are able, using these tools, to see Ida as never before. Ida is a warm-blooded creature covered in thick fur. She was just under a meter long, including her tail, which she used for balance as she scampered on all fours through the rainforest canopy. Her opposable thumbs and toes gripped the branches. Ida was probably active at night. Like us, her two large forward-facing eyes gave her excellent stereoscopic vision.
Let me try to take you back to Ida's time, the Eocene period. Now, 47 million years ago, I would have been standing underwater. This was the bed of a huge volcanic lake, the Metal Pit. Now, the animals that lived around in the tropical rainforest would have come to the waters to drink, but bubbling up from the surface was poisonous carbon dioxide, and the animals, like Ida, would have been gassed and fallen in and drowned, and then ended up sinking to the bottom into the mud and effectively being pickled, slowly embalmed and perfectly preserved. And millions of years later, that mud turned to shale. And thousands of incredibly preserved creatures have been dug up here. Bats, lizards, species of crocodiles, all sorts of things, including miniature horses the size of dogs. It's quite slippy here. Now, this gives you some idea of the sort of things that have been dug up here. This is a bowfin, 47 million years old, probably like Ida. And you can see the tail here and even the gills. And there are literally thousands of fish and other animals here still waiting to be dug up. Ida, though, is something special. She is the most complete fossil primate ever found. And as well as a perfectly preserved skeleton, there's the shadow outline of her fur. You can see the contents of her stomach and know that her last meal was berries. And she is something else that's important too. A link, in some way, a distant ancestor of us all. Perhaps not our great-great-great grandmother, but some distant cousin on the family tree. And in the 150th year since the publication of The Origin of Species, surely Charles Darwin would have been delighted by Ida.
After Jørn Hurum first acquired the fossil for the Oslo Natural History Museum, he invited a select group of scientists to work with him in total secrecy. He formed what he called his dream team.
I knew immediately that this fossil was too important, so I started to invite people in to make a dream team around this fossil. To make the first description really proper, if I would do it alone, I'm not an expert in primates, but there are some good people around the world, and I invited the best ones to join me, and they all said yes.
Each member of the dream team was securely sent one image. What they saw astounded them. Top dental expert, Dr. Holly Smith.
In terms of a complete skeleton, it's hard to think of anything else in primate evolution that's as complete as this fossil. Certainly the most beautiful fossil primate I've ever seen.
Leading primate specialist, Professor Philip Gingerich.
Well, it's really a kind of Rosetta Stone because it ties together parts we haven't been able to associate before.
Expert fossil hunter, Dr. Jens Frantzen.
This is by far the most complete fossil primate ever found on the world. And we have not only the complete skeleton, but we have also the complete soft body outline, and we have the gut content. So what do you want more, yeah?
So suddenly I had this dream team that I could work with, and I'm learning a lot from them all the time when working with them on this project.
Ida's fossilized remains originated from the Messel Pit. Located 30 kilometers south of Frankfurt in Germany, the pit has been a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1995. But the environment here was very different during Ida's lifetime.
At that time, 47 million years ago, there was evidently a greenhouse climate in Central Europe. We can reconstruct that Messel must have been situated about where Sicily is today, so in the middle of the Mediterranean. Well, you would be standing at a small freshwater lake, really situated as an eye in a tropical forest. Green waters, because evidently there are many algae around, just giving the water a greenish color. And then there was a dense rainforest of tropical kind around. And then the weather was nice, was warm. Perhaps it was raining from time to time. So this is the picture you have to imagine when you are trying to get back 47 million years, just traveling back in your mind.